This video will go over the FudsChem workflow and give the basics of how to run a project in FudsChem from start to finish. FudsChem is a comprehensive data management platform available to USACE personnel and contractors to support the investigation, remediation, and monitoring of formerly used defense sites. FudsChem has the capacity to store all chemical, geological, and hydrogeological data associated with these sites. The system can be used to plan sampling events, track projects, validate analytical data, generate final reports, perform data usability assessments, and view data in spatial systems. While all of these tools are available to contractors and USACE personnel, they are not always required. The workflow models for contractor and USACE performed projects are provided in the user guide, which is located at FudsChem.com on the Resources System Documentation tab before you log in. It can alternatively be accessed under Quick Links User Guide after logging in. Types of data that are required for active projects by the FUDS program are shown on each workflow. Recommended data types are also shown. USACE project managers need to determine which workflow will be used for their projects, along with which, if any, other data will also be required. To determine which data will be required for a specific project, please refer to your contract. This video will assume that all possible data is being loaded. We will also assume that a contractor is loading the data rather than the core doing the work internally. As soon as you kick off the project, reach out to your Synectics point of contact to activate the project in FudsChem. If you do not know who to reach out to, go to FudsChem.com and click Support before logging in. The support phone number and email, FUDS.support@Synectics.net, are listed here. Additionally, your Synectics point of contact can make sure everyone working on the project is provided with a login and can access the project and applicable tools. For more information, please refer to our FudsChem Permissions Overview video, linked in the description. The first step in FudsChem is creating an EQAP and establishing locations. We recommend both of these steps to be completed 90 days prior to sampling. However, your project may require a different timeline. We'll discuss the general workflow for these steps in this video, but please refer to our EQAP playlist for a variety of EQAP tutorials and our loading locations tutorials for how to complete these steps. These tutorials, along with all other tutorials referenced later in this video, are linked to in the description below. The general workflow for EQAPs is for the contractor to enter information following the steps in our EQAP playlist. These videos are linked in the description. Next, they screen the EQAP and resolve any errors, then certify it. Once certified, the lab gets the chance to review the EQAP and acknowledge it. Please refer to our EQAP lab acknowledgement tutorial for details on how to complete this step. This video is linked in the description. If the lab has any concerns, for example, if the EQAP lists a method the lab no longer runs, they will let the contractor know. The core chemist will uncertify the EQAP to allow the contractor to make updates if necessary. If the lab agrees to report data in accordance with the EQAP, they will click Acknowledge. Note that multiple labs can acknowledge an EQAP if needed. Once all applicable labs have acknowledged the EQAP, the contractor will submit for approval. The core chemist will review the EQAP and, if updates are needed, uncertify so the contractor can update. If no updates are needed, the core chemist will approve the EQAP. Note that 12 months after the approval, the EQAP will expire. The lab will review it again, and if their limits have been updated, provide them to the contractor to update. If no updates are needed, they will re-acknowledge, the contractor will resubmit for approval, and the core chemist will re-approve. The general workflow for locations, as well as most other data types, is for the contractor to enter them under Tools, Data Submission, screen the data to ensure it is error-free, and certify the data. Then a reviewer will review the data and approve it under Tools, Data Approval. For more information on screening for errors, please refer to our Screening Checks overview. For more information on entering location data, refer to our loading locations tutorials.
These videos are linked in the description.
The user will need to populate the location definition and site cross-reference tables to successfully enter data into FudsChem. These tables are the foundation for all successive data loaded into FudsChem. A clearly defined location with an associated site ensures that data will join seamlessly to the correct geographic point. For more information on entering the site information, please refer to our Location Site XRef Entry tutorial.
This video is linked in the description.
It is recommended to establish locations as early as possible. Location data can be entered with placeholders, then updated once the team goes into the field and establishes exact coordinates. Refer to our Centroids and Placeholders in Location Data overview and our Updating Location Information tutorial for more information.
These videos are linked in the description.
A location ID is not the same as a field sample ID. The location is the geographic coordinates where samples are collected. The samples taken from that location will each be assigned their own field sample ID. Depth and sampling date are not part of the location ID. The location ID is required to be a maximum of 15 characters in length and is made up of uppercase alpha and numeric characters. The hyphen is the only allowable non-alphanumeric character. The recommended location ID consists of three elements: property, location classification type, and sequence, the first two of which are separated by a hyphen.
Please refer to our Best Practices Naming Conventions video, linked in the description, for more information.
Keep in mind that the NAD83 State Plane Coordinate System is preferred by the USACE for location coordinates. Locations entered into FudsChem should be converted to state plane coordinates and reported in U.S. feet. Lithology data, well completion information, and well construction intervals will likely be available when locations are established. The timeline for entering this data will depend on your project. Refer to our Lithology Entry Tutorial, our Well Completion Information Entry Tutorial, and our Well Construction Intervals Entry Tutorial for information on entering these data types.
These videos are linked in the description.
30 days prior to sampling, we recommend using the event management tools in FudsChem to plan your event. Note that your project may require a different timeline. The event planning tool helps manage large datasets by allowing the user to create event tracking reports. These reports update in real time and use color coding to indicate the status of each planned sample. They track the event to ensure samples don't slip through the cracks. Both chemistry and non-chemistry data can be planned and tracked, and it is recommended to plan all applicable data types. Refer to our Event Management tutorial for more information on using the event management tools, and our Event Tracking Reports overview for more information on the event tracking reports.
These videos are linked in the description.
Note that the field sample ID will consist of the following elements: location ID, unique time frame indicator, and QC indicator, if applicable. The field sample ID can be a maximum of 30 characters in length, and is made up of uppercase alpha and numeric characters. The hyphen and underscore are the only allowable non-alphanumeric characters. Spaces should not be included in the field sample ID. Field sample IDs must be unique and cannot be reused in subsequent events for the same project.
Please refer to our Best Practices Naming Conventions video, linked in the description, for more information. The information filled out in Event Management includes which locations will be sampled for which type of data, as well as sampling specifics for the event. All of the information entered into Event Management can be used to pre-populate digital chains of custody for your field team. Refer to our Field Sampling ChemField Entry tutorial for more information. This video is linked in the description.
Once your sampling event starts, data can be entered simultaneously, and event tracking reports will update in real time to ensure no planned samples are skipped. We recommend that field data from your completed chains of custody be entered within 7 days of the end of sampling. However, Your project may require a different timeline. Like location data, field sampling data will be entered under Tools Data Submission and approved under Tools Data Approval. Refer to our Field Sampling ChemField Entry tutorial for more information.
This video is linked in the description.
Data such as environmental measurements or groundwater levels may be collected by the field team during sampling. We recommend that this data be entered within 30 days of the end of sampling. However, your project may require a different timeline. Please refer to our groundwater level entry tutorial and our loading environmental measurements tutorials for more information.
These videos are linked in the description.
It is recommended to start loading lab data as soon as it is available, and complete loading within 21 days after the end of sampling. However, your project may require a different timeline. See our Laboratory Sed Submission tutorial for more information.
This video is linked in the description.
As soon as the laboratory certifies their SED file, FUDSCAN's built-in automated data review processor will automatically begin applying qualifiers. Validators can review, revise, and finalize these qualifiers directly within the FUDSCAN interface. Validation should be completed within 42 days of the end of sampling. However, your project may require a different timeline. For more information, please refer to our validation tutorials.
These videos are linked in the description.
Once validation is finalized, data should be approved by the core chemist within 60 days of sampling ending. However, your project may require a different timeline. Approved data can be viewed in final reports and spatial systems such as Google Earth. Please refer to our Chemistry Data Approval tutorial for more information on approving chemistry data.
This video is linked in the description.
Once all data in an event is approved, it is ready for a data usability assessment. Please refer to our Data Usability Assessment tutorial and Data Usability Assessment Reports Overview for more information.
These videos are linked in the description. The steps of your project workflow can be tracked in the Project Tracking Report found on the FUDSCAM dashboard, or under Reports, Event Tracking Reports, Project Tracking Report. It conveniently highlights cells that are approaching the recommended completion dates.
For example, if the sampling event is within 90 days and the EQAP has not yet been approved, the report will highlight in yellow to alert you. For more information, refer to our Project Tracking Report Overview.
This video is linked in the description.
A set of performance metrics reports is also available on the dashboard to track the amount of time that has passed for loading field data, loading lab data, validating data, and approving data. This report can be customized to show project-specific expected loading times if the default time frame listed in this video is not appropriate for your project. For more information, refer to our Performance Metrics Reports Overview.
This video is linked in the description.
Don't forget to subscribe to the FUDSCAM YouTube channel for more tutorial videos. All of the tutorials and playlists mentioned during this video are linked in the description below. Lastly, if you have questions or comments, feel free to contact us at fuds.support@synectics.net. Thank you.